Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover one of the most useful statistics used in the laboratory, the coefficient of variation. Let's start with a definition. The coefficient of variation is the ratio of the standard deviation to the mean. This is expressed as a percentage. In shorthand, you'll often see the coefficient of variation expressed as CV. This is the formula for the coefficient of variation. Let's pick it apart so that you can understand it. S represents the standard deviation. Bar X is the mean. So, this part of the formula requires us to divide the standard deviation by the mean. The result is multiplied by 100 in order to express it as a percentage. I encourage you to take a look at our video for calculating the mean if you'd like additional information. We also have a video that covers standard deviation. Now that we understand how the formula works, let's practice by plugging some numbers into it. Let's move our formula down to the corner, just in case we need it. These are the values for our standard deviation and the mean. Let's begin by copying down the formula and then substituting the values for the standard deviation and the mean. Next, we'll divide the SD by the mean. The result is 28 thousandths. Finally, we multiply by 100 in order to have a percentage. Now let's do a little practice. The next segment of the video shows a mean and an SD that you can use to practice calculating the CV. Pause the video when the mean and the SD appear. This will give you a chance to grab pen, paper, or a calculator. Calculate the CV, then restart the video. I'll provide the correct answer and how I got it. Here's our SD and our mean. Remember that our formula is in the corner. Go ahead and pause the video now. The CV is 3.6%. Here's how I got that figure. First, I entered the mean and the SD into the formula. I divided the SD by the mean. The result was 36 thousandths, which was then multiplied by 100. The result was a CV of 3.6%. Now that you know how to calculate a CV, let's talk a little bit about application. The CV allows the technologist to make easier comparisons of the overall precision. Since the standard deviation typically increases as the concentration of the analyte increases, the CV can be regarded as a statistical equalizer. Let's look at an illustration of this point. Let's imagine a situation where a technologist is comparing precision for two different glucose methods, and they're only using standard deviation. The SD for the hexokinase method, let's say it's 4.8, and it's 4.0 for glucose oxidase. If the SD is the only thing that's considered, they might incorrectly assume that the glucose oxidase method is more precise. However, if we consider the CV, it might show that both methods are equally precise. Assume the mean for hexokinase is 120, and the glucose oxidase mean is 100. It turns out that the CV for both methods is 4%, so they're equally precise. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. Following videos in this series will cover standard deviation index and the coefficient of variation ratio. For all of your QC needs, go to www.qcnet.com.